Should stay at 68 Canelo. 175 is too big.
No, I think Canelo is fine at 75 and 60. It don't matter what way he go to. I think he's fine. Yeah.
From all of the top fighters, you know, who do you see giving you the first shot at greatness by actually fighting?
Out of the fighters, like the top guys.
Yeah.
Probably Spence or Bud. Whoever the one between Spence and Bud if they fight. I feel like one of them will give me a shot. If not, I'll be fighting for a vacant belt.
What was your reaction to between Spence and Crawford if it does take place?
Say that one more time.
Who do you favor in that matchup if it does take place?
I mean, you can't favor just one person. They two great fighters, you know. And we want to know who's going to win until they step in the ring on fight night, you know.
But your opponents told me you hit harder than anyone else. Where does that come from? Is it technique? Is it God-given?
I think it's God-given. Strength, and you know, I don't be forcing it. It's natural, you know.
Just the guy that's gonna prove to your critics that you are as real as you seem to be. I think we're all pretty convinced here, but some of the your future potential opponents or peers, fighters, pugilists, they don't feel that you still gotta prove that. You know, you gotta.
Yeah, I don't gotta prove nothing to nobody but myself. You know, I ain't worried about what nobody's saying. None of that stuff bothers me. As long as I'm doing my thing and winning. And put myself in a position to, you know, win a world title. That's all that, man. I ain't worried about what nobody else got to say.
What was your reaction to Spence knockout over Ugas?
That was a great fight. Spence looked real good. He did a good job. He actually looked better this time than the last time we fought Danny. So he looked way better.
I would imagine you're thinking more of the long game for opportunities, right, Jerome? Like, you know, 3-4 years is when you'll get, you know, the opportunity that you're looking for just based on how the title picture is?
I feel like I'll get my opportunity sooner than that.
Yeah?
I feel like by the end of the year, maybe 2023.
Can I just say that? Because look how long it's taken for, like, Spence and Crawford, you know, to fight.
I mean, after they fight, it's going to be either I fight one of them or I'll be fighting for a vegan belt. So I feel like I'm only, like, one or two fights away from, you know, world title.
Do you feel bored here? Because, you know, the fighters will say what they say about you. Some will say good, some will say bad. Sean Porter's retired. He said what he said. I didn't caught wind of that. Yeah. But do you feel you avoided at all by any of them?
I mean, you could say that, but I feel like ain't no fighter scared of nobody. I feel like they just make this smart business decisions and what's best for their career. I mean, I'll see these guys, whether it's at 47 or 54.
What was your reaction to Canelo's loss to Bivo, and were you surprised how easily Bivo beat Canelo?
I was surprised about that. You know, I was shocked. I didn't think Bivo was going to be able to do that much with Canelo, but, you know, he shocked us. Well, he shocked me, for sure.
Is he far from the prototypical European fighter? Is he far from the...
Say that one more time.
Is he far from the prototypical European fighter? Like, his style, is it different from a Russian-based fighter?
I like his style. He actually good, you know. He's sharp. He take his time. He real technical. So, I think I like him. I like he gained a fan.
Do you always wrap your own hands?
Yeah, I always wrap my own hands.
Why is that?
Yeah, you're one of the few.
I've been doing this since the amateurs. I wrap my own hands. I don't like how like some people make it too tight, and how you gotta redo it and stuff like that. So I know what I like. So I just do it to. You know, do it to my feeling.
And Boots, what's the difference with you and Terrence Crawford?
The difference?
Mm-hmm.
We got two different styles. A lot of people say we fight alike, but we don't fight alike. I got my own style. He got his own style. But I feel like I'm just sharper, smarter, you know, stronger, wiser. You know, I'm great at everything. I'm naturally gifted on both sides, power on both sides. I could fight, you know, I could fight on one side for a whole fight if I have to. So.
If you can't get the champions right now, do you want Virgil Ortiz or Conor Benn? What's your thoughts on those fights?
Well, it don't matter to me. They already know that any and everybody. I don't care who it is. They can line them up. We will knock them down. No matter who it is.
As soon as Canelo lost, Terrence Crawford tweeted out, we know who number one is, kind of... saying that he's number one. Would you agree with that? And if not, who would you put at number one, man? I know, aside from yourself. Like.
I mean, I put myself at number one, but I mean, you could pick him. You could pick Errol Spence or Bud at number one. So.
It shouldn't be Bivol because he did be the number one.
I mean, you can put him in the top 10. I mean, if you beat him again, he got to be top five or at least number one.
Where do you have yourself ranked?
Number one.
Hey, we got Haney and Cambosas coming up, man. Who you got in that fight?
Say that one more time.
We got Devin Haney and Cambosas coming up. Who you got in that fight?
Devin Haney and Cambosas. That's going to be a great fight. But I'm rocking with the young champ. You know, I'm rocking with Devin. Devin going to be smart, do his thing, you know, and go in there and box, you know, and do what he need to do.
All right, how about Tank and Rollies?
Tank and Rolly, that's a good fight, but I think Tank gonna do his thing. You know, I'm rocking with Tank.
You know, what do you make of your opponent, John? What do you think he's gonna bring that maybe we haven't seen from the other opponents, or what do you think he'll bring out of you?
Honestly, I don't really know. I don't really watch film on people that I'll be fighting unless I've seen it from like the past. But I'm not sure. I let my team do that, you know, looking at the guys and stuff like that. I don't be too worried about that.
What have they told you to expect?
Nothing really. We just doing me.
Yeah.
Doing what I always do.
You go in there, you make the adjustments as suit, right?
Like, yeah, I figure them out within like 30 seconds, you know. I just see how they come in and I break them down.
So, Ron, what do you think about the main event? To the fight you were on, Charlo versus Castaño. Who should be more confident going into that rematch?
I mean, they both should be confident. It was a great fight. You know, it was a good war. You know, but I think Charlo gonna win this time. And I think he got him figured out. And I think he gonna win this time.
Why do you say that? Why do you think he's got him figured out?
I think he got it figured out because I know he probably watched the tape and saw a couple things that he was doing. And when he was like towards the end of the, you know, the fight, he was picking it up and he was actually looking better. So I think he's gonna pick it up a little earlier, and I think he's gonna try to go for a knockout.
How about your fight? How's your fight gonna go?
How my fight gonna go? You already know how my fight gonna go. Me putting on the show, you know, being in the ring, being dominant, you know, getting that knockout at the end of the night, you know, making a big statement. I gotta make a big statement.
And as a Philly native, how do you feel? How do you think is different, the vibe from your fans on the East Coast versus the West?
I mean, I'm gaining my fan base over here on the West Coast, and I'm loving it. And it's different, but, you know, everybody gravitate to me because I got a fan-friendly style. So.
How does it feel to be performing at such a legendary venue like the Dignity here in L.A.?
It feels great to be performing here. You know, I can't wait to shine, you know, in front of, you know, some new fans and, you know, get the